In this video, I'll be showing how to develop forecasts in Excel for time series data with seasonality but without trend. I'm going to start by copying the table and paste transpose so the years can be in columns. I'll delete the old table. Type year in first column and quarter in the second. I'm going to type equals sequence 4 here to return an array of 1 to 4 in 4 rows. I'll copy and paste for quarters 2, 3, and 4. I'll title the time series data sales and drag its values from the table here. Delete the columns. I'm going to highlight the data, click Insert, then select this scatter chart with straight line and markers. We see a pattern here that indicates seasonality, but there is no trend since the values are not increasing or decreasing over time. It indicates that the appropriate model to develop is one with seasonality but without trend. To use regression, we first define indicator variables. Let Q1 equal 1 if quarter 1 and 0 otherwise. Same for Q2 and Q3. Then quarter 4 will be what we call the reference or omitted category, where Q1, Q2, Q3 are all zeros. So we set up indicator variables for Q1, Q2, and Q3. I'm going to type 1, 2, 3 up here for quarters 1, 2, and 3. To generate the ones and zeros, I'm going to use the if function. So if the quarter number in column B matches the column number in row 1, return 1, otherwise return 0. Note that the dollar sign before B here restricts us to column B, and the dollar sign before 1 restricts us to row 1. I'm going to enter and drag to fill the remaining cells. The setup is now complete. To run regression, click Data, Data Analysis, select Regression, click OK. For the Y range, select the time series values, and for the X range, select the indicator values. I'm going to check labels here because I selected the titles. For the output, I want it to be somewhere on this sheet. Click OK. We only need the coefficients from this output, so I'm going to copy it and paste it up here. Delete the output. The regression equation is therefore as shown. Now, suppose I want to forecast any other year. For quarter 1, only Q1 will be 1. Q2 and Q3 will be 0. So I'll take the intercept, lock it down with F4, and add it to Q1 coefficient. I can then drag down for Q2 to Q4. This will be the forecast for any year since there is no trend. Note that we can also obtain this forecast by simply averaging the values for each quarter. For quarter 1, equal average, hold down the Ctrl key and select all quarter 1 values. Enter and drag down for the rest. You can see the results are the same. In essence, the forecasts are just averages. I'm going to sum this up and calculate ratios by dividing each forecast by the total. Since we have 4 seasons to obtain seasonal indices, we multiply the ratios by 4. Those should add up to 4. For easy interpretation, we can subtract 1 from each seasonal index. Converting them to percents, we can say that quarter 1 sales are 25% below quarterly average, and quarter 4 sales are 15% above average. Finally, suppose projected total sales for a particular year is 420. We can estimate sales for that year by multiplying the seasonal ratios by 420, and those should add up to 420. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.